This is Tarun, and today in this lecture we will be doing the ordinary differential equation part 2. In the part 1 lecture we have discussed about the Laplace transform, and in this particular lecture there will be no such topic. So this is, you can say, very beginning of the ordinary differential equation. So first of all, we must know what is an ordinary differential equation and what are various terms like degree, order of a differential equation. So differential equation is a combination of, you can say, derivatives, like derivative, first derivative, second derivative, third, fourth, and or anything. It's a combination in combination of different type of, you can say, that order of differentiation in a form of equation. Equation means there will be sign of equal will be there. Okay, so the degree and the order. So as we can see that I have written this differential equation. So the degree is the first of all, we must note the order. Order is the highest derivative of the differential equation. That is, the highest derivative of this differential equation is 2. That is the double derivative. And the degree is the highest power of the highest order. That is, highest order is 2. The order is the 2 and the degree will be 3, not the 5. Because we have to check out the degree, or you can say that power of the highest order. The highest order is 2 and the degree of the highest order is 3. So the degree will be 3 and the order will be 2. Okay, so the solution of differential equation, we can solve the differential equation by various method, like variable separable, homogeneous equation, or we can get equation in the linear equation form. Then we can solve out like that, in this form, dy by dx plus py equals to qx, where this integrating factor will be e raised to the power px dx. Then the equation will be y into integrating factor equals to q into integrating factor, then multiply these and again do the integration with respect to x, then that will be your answer. These things, you can say that this is the basic which you can do from the 12th class NCERT. If you feel any, you can say, difficulty, then you are always welcome to put your doubts into the comment box section, or I have already created a, you can say, that group on WhatsApp, so that you can share your doubts at there. So officially our students' syllabus starts from this point. Exact differential equation, first portion. For example, a differential equation is of the form m dx plus n dy equals to 0. This is the form which is given, but here mx plus ny should not be equal to 0, and if we calculate the derivative of m with respect to y and n with respect to x, so if both comes out to be equal, then we said that differential equation is exact, and the solution will be, just do the integration of the m portion with respect to x and n portion with respect to y, but keep this point in mind that in the I exclude all the term which contains x, or just directly put x equals to 0. Then if you will have any values in the terms of y, then only integrate those values. Exclude all the values that containing x when you are doing the integration with respect to y. But when there will be terms related to the y in the first portion, then keep them as a constant. Okay, now the next point, integrating factor by inspection. So that is the differentiation of x and y. You can calculate it with this in the terms of u into v formula. Again, that is a u by v formula, you can solve out it. Next, tangent inverse y by x, log of y by x, log of x into y, all this formula you can check. This, they will be, you can say, of use when you will be solving the questions. Next, integrating factor for a homogeneous equation. Homogeneous equation means the value, the power will be equal. For example, x and y, that means the power is 2. For example, somewhere you will be finding x square, y square, xy. That means, and what I'm saying that if x square, xy, y square, all these three terms, x square, xy, y, the power is 2, means the degree is homogeneous, degree is same. That means homogeneous equation. Okay, so if you find that there is an equation which is in the form of this, then the integrating factor will be 1 by mx plus ny. What is the significance of this integrating factor? Its significance is that after multiplying the equation by this integrating factor, you will be able to make your differential equation as a exact differential equation, and after that just do the same procedure, integrating m with respect to dx and n with respect to dy, and always keep this point in mind that exclude the terms that contain x in the second portion the integration. Okay, next, if you find any terms related to f1xy into y dx plus f2xy into x into dy, then always check that integrating factor will be 1 by mx minus ny. Okay, now next, when mx m dx plus n dy equals to 0, and if you are calculating these two points, like first point m, the differentiation of m with respect to y, that is del m by del y minus del n by del x, when you divide the difference between by the n, if then you get the function in the term of f of x, then integrating factor will be e raised to the power integration f of x dx, and if you are multiplying by m, then you are getting in with respect to m, because with respect to y, because n correspond to x and m correspond to y. As we have seen, m correspond to, we are doing the differentiation with respect to y. m वाले केस में m के साथ डिफरेंशिएशन करना है, और n वाले में x के साथ. सबसे पहले किसी भी क्वेश्चन, कोई भी क्वेश्चन दिख जाता है डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन का, योर फर्स्ट पॉइंट शुड बी जस्ट कैलकुलेट द डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ m विद रिस्पेक्ट टू y एंड डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ n विद रिस्पेक्ट टू x, एंड आफ्टर दैट जस्ट डू द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू, जस्ट कैलकुलेट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दीज टू, एंड देन ट्राई दैट जो ये डिफरेंस है ये किस नंबर से डिवाइड हो सकता है, वेदर बाय n और वेदर बाय n. ओके, आफ्टर दैट जस्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट जस्ट कैलकुलेट द इंटीग्रेटिंग फैक्टर. नेक्स्ट, ऑर्थोगोनल ट्रैजेक्टरी, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. मेनी क्वेश्चन हैव बीन आस्ड फ्रॉम दिस ऑर्थोगोनल ट्रैजेक्टरी. इस बहुत ही सिंपल है, कुछ भी नहीं होता, सिंपली कोई भी क्वेश्चन दिया होता है उसका जस्ट डू द डिफरेंशिएशन विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स और वाई, वट एवर इट इज गिवन. मेनली देयर विल बी टू फॉर्म, दैट इज कार्टीजियन फॉर्म एंड अनदर वन विल बी पोलर फॉर्म. इन कार्टीजियन जस्ट कैलकुलेट द डिफरेंशिएशन एंड एलिमिनेट ऑल द कॉन्स्टेंट वैल्यू, आफ्टर दैट जस्ट रिप्लेस द डी वाई बाई डी एक्स बाय माइनस ऑफ डी एक्स बाई डी वाई, एंड आफ्टर दैट जस्ट अगेन डू द सिंपल इंटीग्रेशन, कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू, एंड इन द पोलर फॉर्म जस्ट डू द सिंपल डिफरेंशिएशन, दैट इज डी आर बाई डी थीटा, आफ्टर दैट रिप्लेस दिस डी आर बाई डी थीटा बाय माइनस आर स्क्वायर डी थीटा बाय डी आर. ओके, नाउ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, वी विल बी डूइंग सम क्वेश्चंस लाइक डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स एंड इट्स डेरिवेटिव फर्स्ट डिग्री होनी चाहिए, दैट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. मीन्स द डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, दैट इज फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम सेइंग दैट वाई इक्वल्स टू समथिंग लाइक दैट एक्स प्लस समथिंग, वेयर एक्स इज ए इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एंड वाई विल बी डिपेंडेंट, बट देन इट मीन्स दैट द डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, दैट इज वाई एंड इट्स डेरिवेटिव, दैट इज वाई वन वाई टू वाई थ्री, दैट शुड बी द फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव. मीन्स इट शुड बी डी वाई बाय डी एक्स रेज टू द पावर टू, इट शुड नॉट बी ऑफ द सेकेंड ऑर्डर. द डिग्री कैन बी एनीथिंग, सॉरी द डेरिवेटिव कैन बी एनीथिंग, बट द डिग्री शुड बी फर्स्ट डिग्री. द डेरिवेट, द ऑर्डर ऑफ द डिफरेंशिएशन कैन बी एनीथिंग, बट द डिग्री शुड बी वन ओनली. ओके, सो हियर द ऑपरेटर डी विल बी काउंटेड एज डेल बाय डेल एक्स डी बाय डी एक्स, सो द सोल्यूशन विल बी कैलकुलेटेड एज द कंप्लीट सोल्यूशन विल बी द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री फंक्शन प्लस पर्टिकुलर इंटीग्रेशन, एंड फॉर द कैलकुलेटिंग द दिस एंड फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग दिस कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री फंक्शन वी आर रिक्वायर टू कैलकुलेट दिस ऑक्सिलरी इक्वेशन इक्वल्स टू जीरो, एंड देन वी विल कैलकुलेट, एंड पर्टिकुलर इंटीग्रेशन वी विल बी सीइंग व्हेन वी विल बी टेकिंग द क्वेश्चन. नाउ द वर्किंग रूल, व्हेन ऑल द रूल्स आर पॉजिटिव, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग दैट दिस इज एप्लीकेबल टू दैट सी एफ, वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग फॉर सी एफ नाउ. ओके, सी एफ मीन्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री फंक्शन. फॉर दिस कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री फंक्शन दिस इज ए, दिस इज ए मीन्स फॉर एग्जाम्पल, एग्जाम्पल कहाँ पे है, एग्जाम्पल नहीं किया मैंने. ओके, एग्जाम्पल करना चाहिए था. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू जस्ट अज्यूम दैट दिस इज द फॉर्म डी माइनस, मीन्स जो भी कोफिशेंट्स है ना, कोफिशेंट किस चीज़ के, वाई के बाद की जो भी वैल्यूज हैं, उस चीज़ को जीरो पुट कर दो. फॉर एग्जांपल d माइनस एम वन डी माइनस एम टू इन टू वाई इक्वल टू जीरो, देन d की वैल्यू दो आ गई एम वन एंड एम टू. इफ़ ऑल रूट्स आर रियल, फॉर एग्जांपल एम वन एम टू दीज आर रियल, देन द कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री फंक्शन विल बी सी वन दैट इज कॉन्स्टेंट इन टू ई रेज टू द पावर एम वन एक्स प्लस सी टू ई रेज टू द पावर एम टू एक्स. अगेन द टू रूट्स रियल एंड इक्वल. फॉर एग्जाम्पल देर आर टू रूट्स, बोथ आर रियल बट बोथ आर इक्वल ऑल्सो, देन वट विल हैपन, देन इट विल बिकम c1 प्लस c2x टू एक्स इन टू ई रेज टू द पावर एम एक्स, दैट इट विल बिकम c1 प्लस c2x. इफ द टू रूल्स टू रूट्स ऑफ द ऑक्सिलरी इक्वेशंस आर इमेजनरी, फॉर एग्जाम्पल दीज आर इमेजनरी, देन वट विल हैपन, m1 इज दिस एंड m2 इज दिस, देन वट विल हैपन, e रेज टू द पावर अल्फा एक्स, मीन्स रियल पार्ट विल ऑलवेज गो विद द एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन एंड द रियल और इमेजनरी फंक्शन विल बी विद द ट्रिग्नोमेट्री, दैट इज c1 into cos beta x plus c2 sin beta x. Okay, where c1 is equal to c1 plus c2 and c2 equals to I into c1 minus c2. If both the pair of the imaginary roots are equal, here we are taking that roots imaginary home. But if what will happen if both roots of the imaginary, we can say auxiliary equations are imaginary but both are equal, then what will happen? Then again for equal just do this c2 plus c1x plus c2 plus c1x into cos beta x plus c3 plus c4, you can multiply by anyone x, you can take x with this c3 or x you can take with c4 into sin beta x and multiply that complete with e raised to the power alpha x for the real port, for the real portion. Here 1 by f of d means what this means, 1 by f of d, for example this is y, f of d into y equal to x, then this y will become 1 by f of d into x. So this 1 by f of d, this can be anything, for example this d, 1 by d, d means in differentiation, or 1 by d means ulta reverse of that differentiation is integration, means 1 by d means we are required to do the integration and d means we are required to do the differentiation. And when wherever we get this d minus a into x, then do this e raised to the power ax, integrate x in this, the x means this can be anything, x means function, that function can be anything, exponential, trigonometric, algebraic, it can be anything, e raised to the power ax, jo bhi ye sign diya hua na iske opposite sign, jaise ye minus hai to plus yahan pe aa jayega aur jo bhi sign ye hai wo andar chala jayega, means x ke sath e raised to the power minus ax. Okay, now for finding the particular integration, अब हम रूल्स वो देखते हैं, लिखते हैं कंडीशंस और यू कैन से दैट केसेस, जब ये एक्स जो हम ये लेके चल रहे हैं एक्स एक्स एक्स, ओके, इफ दिस एक्स इज एक्सपोनेंशियल देन व्हाट विल हैपन, जब हम एक्सपोनेंशियल फंक्शन लेंगे देन द कोफिशियंट ऑफ एक्स दैट इज हियर ए, इन दिस केस द कोफिशियंट इज ए, सो वी विल पुट दिस वैल्यू ऑफ डी एज इज इक्वल्स टू ए, देन वी विल रिप्लेस दिस डी बाय ए. For example, this f of d is something like 1 plus d square plus d, then we will replace this d by a. Whatever is the coefficient, just replace this d by that and solve that. If after putting the value of d is equal to a, if f of a becomes 0, then what we will do? We will do the differentiation, and for that doing the differentiation, we will put a sign of x and calculate the differentiation. After again, if we put the value of d at d equal to a in this form, if we again get the value at 0, then again we will do another time differentiation, that becomes x square. So it will be you can say that long chain process. If we are not getting a constant value, or you can say that if we are continuously getting 0, then we will be continuing doing the differentiation, and the number of time we are doing the differentiation, we will keep multiplying by x. One time differentiation, then put x. Two time differentiation, put x square and double dash. Three time x cube and f triple dash. Okay, so the number of time you are differentiating, the number of time you have to multiply by x. Now if x is as a trigonometric function, then what we will do? We will replace this d square by minus of a square. What is a? The coefficient of the angle in the terms of x. जो भी एंगल के अंदर x का कोफिशियंट है, उसका जो भी कोफिशियंट है उसका स्क्वायर का माइनस से हम मल्टी रिप्लेस कर देंगे d स्क्वायर को. ओके, एंड व्हेनेवर देयर इज एक्सपोनेंशियल जस्ट सिंप्लीफाई. सो वी विल टेक this understand this complete procedure with an example. So the question is d square y over dx square minus 2 dy by dx plus y plus x into e raised to the power x sin x. Now auxiliary equation means this d square minus 2d plus 1. I am taking it d square because that it is the double derivative. Okay, so it is d square, it is 2 into d, 2d plus 1. So this this is the auxiliary equation. Put this equals to 0. What do you get? D square d minus 1 raised to the power 2 equals to 0. So we are having the two values. D is equal to 1. So the complementary function will be x into c1 plus c2 into e raised to the power x. क्योंकि जो भी वैल्यू है वही यहाँ पे चली जाती है. तो कोफिशियंट कितना हो गया यहाँ पे 1. तो 1 इंटू एक्स दैट इज e रेज टू द पावर x. नाउ पर्टिकुलर इंटीग्रेशन 1 बाय दैट इज टेक इट टू दैट दिस साइड डिनोमिनेटर पोर्शन. सो व्हाट इट बिकम्स 1 बाय d माइनस 1 रेज टू द पावर 2 x इंटू e रेज टू द पावर x इंटू साइन x. नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन, वी आर टेकिंग दिस x आउटसाइड. इफ वी टेक फ्रॉम दिस पोर्शन, मतलब जो भी ये ब्रैकेट के अंदर जो पोर्शन है इससे हम ये x को इससे बाहर लेके जा रहे हैं, देन व्हाट विल हैपन, जो भी कोफिशियंट है उस कोफिशियंट को रिप्लेस कर देंगे, कोफिशियंट को सब्सटीट्यूट कर देंगे इस d के अंदर. मतलब जैसे कि यहाँ पे 1 है तो यहाँ पे रिप्लेस कर देंगे d को d प्लस 1. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यहाँ पे होता e रेज टू द पावर माइनस x, तो यहाँ पे d को रिप्लेस करते हैं हम d माइनस 1 से, बिकॉज हियर इट इज e रेज टू द पावर x. सो वी विल रिप्लेस दिस d बाय d प्लस 1. दिस इज द फॉर्मूला. ओके, सो इट विल बिकम d प्लस 1 माइनस 1, d प्लस 1 माइनस 1 होल स्क्वायर. दिस माइनस 1 प्लस 1 कैन कैंसल्ड. सो इट बिकम्स e रेज टू द पावर x ओवर 1 बाय d स्क्वायर x इनटू sin x. सो d स्क्वायर मींस 1 बाय d स्क्वायर मींस डबल इंटीग्रेशन. सो वी हैव टू डू द इंटीग्रेशन टू टाइम्स. फर्स्ट वी हैव टू डू द इंटीग्रेशन, सॉरी वी हैव टू डू द इंटीग्रेशन टू टाइम्स, डबल इंटीग्रेशन. फर्स्ट टाइम वी हैव इंटीग्रेटेड वी गेट दिस, अगेन वी डू द इंटीग्रेशन वी गेट दिस. आफ्टर डूइंग दैट just add these two functions, that is complementary function and particular integral. After that we get CS, that is complete solution. Okay, so in 2015 now we will be doing only the questions which UPSC have given in the past years. In 2015 the 10 marks equation was given, x cos x plus this is the statement is given. So dy by dx will be equals to, if what I can make it in the linear form, if I divide by this the complete equation, if I divide this complete equation by this factor, what I get is that dy by dx plus y, this becomes x by cos x, x get cancelled, that will become 10x plus that x cos x will be eliminated, it will become 1 by x, and here x and this cos will go into the numerator part, it will become secant x. So it will become in the linear equation of the form dy by dx equals plus py is equals to q. Here the integrating factor will be tangent x e raised to the power tangent x plus 1 by x integration. So the integration of tangent x is log of secant x and 1 by x is log x. So both are in the product form, both are in the log, and both are in the addition. So we can rewrite it as log of ab, that is log of x into secant x. So this will get cancelled. So integrating factor will be x into secant x. So the solution will be y into x secant x, that is equal to x secant x, that is the integrating factor, into the right hand portion, that is q, that is secant x into x, that is secant x into x. This x will get cancelled, secant into secant, that is secant square. The integration of secant square is tangent x. So we get your answer. Okay, very easy for the 10 marks. Now for the 2015, this question is given, solve this differential equation, this is given. So first of all this type of question hote hain, un questionon mein jo bhi ye m hai aur n hai, iska sabse pehle differentiation nikalo. For such type of question, always calculate the differentiation with respect to y and with respect to x of what, m with respect to y and n with respect to x. So we have calculated, we get this. If I subtracted from this by this, then what I get, and divide by m, then I found that the it will become 4 by minus 1 by 4 y. So the integrated factor will be e raised to the power minus 4 by y dy. So it will become e raised to the minus 4 log y. So this minus 4 will go on the power side, so it will become e and log will get cancelled, so it will become y raised to the power minus 4, that is minus 1 by y raised to the power 4. If we multiply the complete equation, this complete equation by 1 by y raised to the power 4, then this non-exact differential equation becomes exact differential equation. What is exact differential equation? Where the derivative of m with respect to y is equal to the derivative of n with respect to x. Then in that case, what we will do? We will just do the simple integration by keeping y as a constant in terms of x, and in the terms of y, neglect all the terms which contain x here, since all the terms contain x, so we will not do the integration in this portion. So it will get 0. So just do the integration of this portion, keeping y as a constant, get your answer. Isn't it very simple question? Yeah, it's very simple question. Now next, for 12 marks in 2015, find the constant a so that x plus y raised to the power a is integrating factor of this equation and hence solve the differential equation. So अब इसने एक स्टेटमेंट के अंदर ही मेंशन कर दिया है कि x plus y raised to the power इसका एक इंटीग्रेटिंग फैक्टर है. अभी तक हमें क्या पढ़ा है? Till now what we have studied is that if what will happen if we get the integrating factor, it will happen that if we are having the integrating factor, if we multiply the equation with integrating factor, then the equation will convert into exact differential equation. So what we will do, we will multiply this equation, this is m, this is n. If we multiply this equation by this and this, and after that if we calculate the differentiation of del m by del y and del n by del y, del x, and we compute them equally, then what we get? We get the value of a, that is a equals to 1. That comes out to be a equals to 1. If we substitute the value of 1 in this equation, and after again just open the multiplication, or just do the multiplication in m into this, after that just do the simple integration and exclude the terms of x in terms while doing the integration with respect to dy. Do not forget to do this, okay? It is very important. Many people get this wrong answer due to that. They just simply do the integration with respect to y. They do not exclude the terms with that also contains x. So you are required to exclude the terms which contain x. After that it becomes very simple. So is question se hame kya sikhne ko mila ki jo bhi integrative factor diya hai usko yadi hum multiplication kar dete hain us differential equation ke andar, matlab what we have learned from this question is that if integrating factor is given, then we just multiply that integrating factor to the differential equation so that our differential equation becomes exact differential equation and we can calculate the integration very easily. Okay, so next question in 2014 for 20 marks. X cube this that. So this question is from the Cauchy's homogeneous linear equation. So in this type of question, what will happen? That you will get higher order, like here the third order, second order, first order, all the order are given. So we will assume x into d by dx, that is capital D, that is the first derivative. If we are second derivative, d into d minus 1, third derivative, d into d minus 1 into d minus 2, fourth derivative, d into d minus 1 into d minus 2 into d minus 3. Okay, so just put replace this value by this d in the d form, and replace this x by e raised to the power z in Cauchy's integral formula, Cauchy's homogeneous linear equation, then z becomes log of x. So when you put log of x as z, then it becomes 65 cos of z, and your left hand side becomes, when you put this value, some values get cancelled and you get d square plus 8 into y, that is 65 into cos z. So many people will calculate this auxiliary equation like this, d cube plus 8 equals to 0. They will calculate that d cube is equals to minus 8, and minus 8 is minus 2 raised to the power 3. Okay, so d has 3 values, d is equal to minus 2, minus 2 and minus 2. It is a wrong way of doing, okay? It will not work like this. So you have to do like this. a cube plus b cube. You have to open the formula of a cube plus b cube like this. D plus 2, that is a plus b plus into a square plus b square minus ab. When you do that, you get the values of d as at minus 2, d as 1 plus minus iota root 3. So this is the value cf equals to c1 e raised to the power minus 2z, because we have converted this x into the term of z. So it will become c1 e raised to the power minus 2z, and this will become c2 cos of, so be imaginary portion hai, that is beta, that is root 3 into z plus c3 sine of root 3z into e raised to the power z, because the real portion is 1, the coefficient of real portion is 1, and we are writing it in the form of z, so it becomes e raised to the power z. So the complementary function in terms of x, just replace e raised to the power z by x. When you replace, you get this, and particular integration becomes very simple, that is 65 cos z divided by dq plus 8. So what I have told in doing the particular integration in terms of when x is given as that x means this portion, this function is given in the term of trigonometric function, then replace this d cube, no sorry, d square by minus of coefficient of z or x, whatever it is given, here it is 1. So the coefficient of 1 xz is 1, so the square of 1 is 1, so replace d square by minus 1. So we can replace this d square by minus 1, because here it is d cube, so I am writing is d square into d, and I am putting d square as minus 1, so it becomes minus d plus 8, that becomes minus d plus 8, that is cos of z. Okay, now it becomes 65 d minus t 8 minus d into cos z. So what I can do is that I just do the you can say that rationalize it, d plus 8 plus d into 8 minus d, so that I can make it like d square, so that I can put the value of d square again. When I put the value of d square again, what is the value of d square? That is minus 1. So minus by minus plus 1. So it becomes 8 raised to the power 2, that is 64. 64 plus 1, 65. So 65 will get cancelled. So it becomes 1, and it becomes 8 plus d into cos of z. So when you open the bracket, what you get? 8 into cos z, that is 8 cos of z, that z means log x, plus d of cos z means cos z, but d means derivative, derivative of cos z means minus sin z, that is minus of sin z, and z is log of x. Just I replace that z by log of x, right? And the complete solution, just add these two, this and this. When you add these two, you get your answer. Next, orthogonal trajectory for 13 marks in 2013, r raised to the power n equals to a sin n theta, that is the first equation which is given. We are required to calculate the orthogonal trajectory of this equation, of this circle. So just do the derivative, first derivative, n aagya gaya, n comes in the front side, n into r raised to the power n minus 1, that is into dr by d theta is equals to a into sin, that is cos n theta into n. So n get cancelled, so it becomes r raised to the power n minus 1 dr by d theta is equals to a into cos of n theta. When I divide this 1 by 2, so this a get cancelled, tan sin theta but a sin theta by cos theta, that becomes tan theta, tan n theta. Okay, so after simplifying, it becomes this, r equals to tan n theta into dr by d theta. Now what we have said, what we have learned that replace this dr by d theta by minus r square d theta by dr. When you replace this, it becomes r equals to minus r square tan theta d theta by dr. It becomes r, one r get cancelled, so it becomes minus dr by dr by r equals to tan n theta into d theta. So the integration of this function will get log of r, and tan theta will become log of secant n theta by n. When you take n towards this side, multiply this side by n, and by this side also n, so it becomes r raised to the power n. So it becomes r raised to the power n. After doing the simplification, you can see what I have done. It's not a matter of deciding. Okay, r raised to the power n equals to c raised to the power minus n, and your answer will be c raised to the power n, that is equals to b into cos of n theta, where this b is c raised to the power minus n, that is a constant only. Okay, so next, in 2013 for 10 marks, this plus this is equals to this, this is m, already mentioned, this is m, this is n. Just do the differentiation with respect to y for the m, and for the n just do the differentiation with respect to x, and after that just do the subtraction of these two, you get 6y. So 6y, which is better to, you can say, divide by n, so divide by n, that is 6xy, so 6y get cancelled. So what you get only 1 by x only, what you get 1 by x, that is 1 by x. So integrating factor will be e raised to the power 1 by x into dx, that is log of x. This e into log x will get cancelled and you are left with only x, that is integrating factor comes out to be x. Now multiply this complete equation by x, after that just do the integration but exclude the terms which contain x. So if you are multiplying by x, then it's you can say that whether if x is present or not present, if you are multiplying with x, then after multiplication there will be x present. So neglect this, just calculate the integration of this first portion with respect to dx only, isn't it? Very simple. Yeah, next, method of variation of parameter. So it's a very good question for the 10 marks. In that type of question, what you have to do, that d square plus y a square into y secant a square x, which we have learned up to now. Okay, so this is auxiliary equation, that is d square plus a square equals to 0, then you d you get equals to plus minus I a, that is iota a, and the complementary function you get. Okay, now after calculating the complementary function, the coefficient of complementary function, that is y1, consider them y1, y2. Okay, now for finding the particular integration for this variation of parameter, means dekho, p for parameter, particular integration, p for parameter means parameter ke liye particular integration ke andar kuch na kuch change hoga. Ab wo change kya ho raha hai ye dekh lo. Y1, write down y1, y2, y2, y1, pehle minus baad mein plus, upar yahan par x, yahan par bx, yahan par bw, yahan par bw, yahan par bx, yahan par bx. Okay, so what is this w? W is just that you can say that determinant of y1, y2, y1 dash into y2 dash. जो ये y1 था ये y2 था, इसका डिफरेंशिएशन नीचे रख दिया, इसका डिफरेंशिएशन नीचे रख दिया, उन दोनों के बाद दोनों का क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई करने के बाद यू कैलकुलेट द डिटरमिनेंट, दैट कम्स आउट टू बी a. सो डिवाइड बाय द डिटरमिनेंट, और जो भी x, x मीन जो राइट पोर्शन में जो भी गिवन, दैट इज e secant ax, जस्ट पुट secant ax एंड secant ax. So sine by secant, that is cos, sine by cos, that is 10, it become tangent. So cos into secant, that becomes 1, so it becomes dx. So just need to do the simple integration and calculate the answer, that is complementary function plus particular integration will give you the complete solution. Okay, so then which you have to remember is this, this is the portion which you have to remember, y1, y2, I have told you the how to remember, just remember this y1, y2, y2, y1, first put minus then plus, after that x by w, x by w you have to do in the both equations, and dx, dx you have to do. Next, find the general equation, solution of the equation, this is the general solution, again this is the double derivative and x is also multiplied, so it is a Cauchy's homogeneous linear equation form, Cauchy's homogeneous linear equation form. For that you replace that double derivative with d into d minus 1, single derivative with d plus constant as 1 into y, that is z into sine of z. When you calculate the auxiliary equation, you get d square plus 1 equals to 0, then d will be equals to plus minus iota, complementary function will become this, particular integration in this case will become 1 by z d square plus z into sine z, because we have replaced this term in the terms, we are not considering this equation in the term of x, we are taking this term in the terms of z, that is e raised to the power z. Now that is z into sine of z. Now how to proceed? We know that sine z we can rewrite in the form of exponential function, because we know that e raised to the power I of z, what is the formula of e raised to the power, that is Euler identity, that is the formula is cos of z plus iota sine of z, this is the formula. Okay, so what I am taking, that I have to calculate the this portion sine z, but what I can do, But it becomes very easy if I solve from the you can say that exponential function. So I'm writing it IP, that is imaginary part of this function e raised to the power iz, which is sin z. Imaginary part of iz is sin z. So I'm indirectly calculating the imaginary part of e raised to the power iz. So imaginary part of e raised to the power iz, when I'm taking it to the first side, then what we have to do, we have to change, or you can say replace this d by d plus I, that is the coefficient of z in terms of exponential power. Okay, so when you do that, it becomes this e raised to the power, when you just open this square and take this d common. After that, when you do the inverse of this, that is 1 plus d by 2i raised to the power minus 1 into z, you just open the binomial expansion of this only for the first term, that will become 1 minus d by 2i into z, because the double derivative or higher derivative of the z will become 0, so no need of writing that. So it becomes e raised to the power iz by 2 into 1 by d into this by this. So 1 by d means integration, so just calculate the integration. After doing the calculation, you get this. After that, just open this e raised to the power iz, that is cos z plus I sin z, just multiply and separate the imaginary and real portion. So just write down the imaginary portion, because we are required to calculate with respect to sin z. If there is cos z, then we will be writing the real portion, and imaginary portion is given, we will be separating the real portion and writing that as in our answer, right? I think you understand it. Yeah, let's proceed further. In 2012, for 20 marks, the question is triple dash minus double dash, that is equal to this. So again, auxiliary equation, just do that. Simple, you can say, taking common and calculating, you get the value as d equals to 0, 0 and 1. So this will be the complementary function, and particular integration will be calculated as d square into d minus 1 into of 12x square plus 6x. Again, 1 by you can do 1 minus d raised to the power minus 1 into this. After that, you just expand this formula and keep it as it is. When you multiply this with this, 1 by this and that, you get this. Again, do the 2 time differentiation, integration, get your answer. This is your answer. Next, for orthogonal trajectory, this x square plus y square equal to ax, calculate the orthogonal trajectory. Again, no need of doing such type of problem in this you can say that form, that is Cartesian form. It's better to do in the polar coordinates. So replace x by r cos theta, y by r sin theta, and put the values in this equation, given equation, that is x square plus y square equals to ax. When you put, you get r square equals to ar cos theta. This one r get cancelled, you get r equals to a cos theta. When r equals to a cos theta, you just do the differentiation of r with respect to theta, you get dr by d theta equals to minus a sin theta. Now replace this a is as r by cos theta, just replace this a by r cos theta, you get this. After doing that, and replace this dr by d theta by minus of r square d theta by dr. After that, this is the point to be remember, because we have to replace this dr by d theta by minus r square d theta by dr, and this is there. Just separate the variable, get your answer. And again, do not forget to change the variables, because the answer we will be getting in the form of polar form, that is r equals to b sin theta. So now just multiply r by both sides, r here. This becomes r square is nothing, just x square plus y square, and this is b, take it as it is, and r sin theta is y. So x square plus y square equals to by, that is our answer. Now for 12 marks, dy by dx equals to 2xy e raised to the power x by y raised to the power 2 divided by y square into 1 plus e raised to the power x by y raised to the power 2. This is the statement given in 2012 question. So in this question, just replace x by v into y, that is also called as homogeneous equation. Okay, so when you replace this, you will put x equals to vy, or you can say that v equals to x by y. When you put, you get this. and again do the differentiation of this x with respect to y, you get dx by dy plus v into y into dv by dy. So you have dx by dy here from here, and you are having dx by dy. It is dy by dx. And what will be the dx by dy? Reciprocal of this. That is the minus one which I have mentioned. Minus one means reciprocal. After doing the reciprocal, you get this. And this is the value. V plus, just equate these two value. You get this minus. When you take the LCM, you get this. After doing that, you get a very simple question. You can solve it. Okay. So in 2013, a question for 10 marks in was asked. The question was, y is a function of x such that the differential coefficient dy by dx is equal to cos x plus y plus sin x plus y. Find out a relation between x and y which is free from any derivative or differential. Okay, so we have to solve this equation in the terms of, we have to calculate the relation between x and y, and the relation should not contain any dy or differential or anything like that. It can contain anything, but you know, it should not be containing anything derivatively, or you can say that differentially. So the question is dy by dx is equals to cos x plus y plus sin x plus y. Now the replace this x plus y by z, so that this x do the differentiation of this function, or you can say this equation with respect to x. Differentiation of x with respect to x becomes 1, so it becomes 1 plus dy by dx equals to dz by dx, and dy by dx will becomes this, dy by dx will become this one, get can minus, that will become minus 1, so it becomes dz by dx minus 1. This is our first equation. Now according to the given question, dy by dx, that is dy by dx is equal to cos z plus sin z, both are dy by dx, so I can put them equal. When I put them equal, I get dz by dx equals to 1 plus cos z plus sin z. So dz, so take it to the left hand side, and take x to the right hand side. X comes to this side and z portion comes to this side. So in such type of you can say that question, always put sin and cos in terms of tan theta, so that we can eliminate this tan and secant, whatever it is given, we can eliminate. So 1 as it is plus cos z is 1 minus 10 square z by 2 divided by 1 plus 10 square z by 2 plus this sin z, it can be replaced by 2 tan z by 2 plus 1 plus 10 square z by 2. You take just LCM of this, it becomes 1 plus 10 square z by 2 plus 1 minus 10 square z by 2 plus 2 tan z by 2, and this denominator part goes to the numerator part, that is 1 plus tangent square equals to secant square. When you put, then this tangent square will get cancelled, 1 plus 1 2, when you get, you can take 2 as a common, that it becomes 1 plus tangent z by 2, that is and equals to integration of x. When you put tangent z by 2 as t, then what you get? Secant square z by 2 into 1 by 2. Okay, 1 by 2 into dx, dz barabar, or you can say equal dt. So take this 2 to the this side, that is this 2. Okay, 2 into dt. So it becomes 2 dt divided by 2 into 1 plus t. So this 2 will get cancelled. So it becomes dt by 1 by 1 plus t. So it becomes log of 1 plus t plus c x plus c, where this t is nothing. T is what? It is tangent, it is tan z by 2, it is tan z by 2. So I am replacing it, 1 plus tan z by 2 equals to x plus c, and z is nothing, it is just x plus y. So I am replacing log of 1 plus tangent of x plus y by 2 equals to x plus c. That is our answer. Okay. So this is the same question which we have seen on the last slide. Okay, alright, so we have completed this lecture, and thanks for watching this video, and if you really like this video, please do not forget to click on the like button, and if you want that the description or the update about uploading of the lectures in the future directly into your email account, then you need to subscribe to us. So you can subscribe by clicking on the subscribe button below at the channel. Okay. So that's all for this lecture, and thank you for watching it.